makes a beat.
What are you doing?
Working.
No, you're concentrating too hard. What are you really doing?
Well, you see, it doesn't make sense that Shelley won't go out with me. So what I've done is I've made a list of my pros and my cons so that she can see that the good outweighs the bad.
Right, and these are your cons?
Right.
Cares too much? Generous to a fault?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, this con makes no sense. Saves babies.
Well, I hadn't finished, actually, what it is. It saves babies, often making him late for work.
No. Realize that she's never gonna buy this.
You know, Laurie, I never understood how good you were at standing around crapping on other people's ideas. Really.
Hey, Laurie, what's going on? You were gonna get me those drug test reports by 2.
I'm working on it.
Okay.
I'm working on it. Did you see the sarcasm in her voice? I'm working on it. Hey, you know what? If you go out with me, then I'll tell you what Laurie says about you behind your back.
No, I don't want to hear all the stuff that Laurie says about me.
All right, dark roots, whatever.
Does Laurie talk about me behind my back?
How long you worked here, Mike? 5 years? You've never come up.
Hey, morning, Mary. Lovely dress you're wearing.
It's not mine. I woke up in it. Evidently, I'm still an alcoholic.
Well, it brings out the red in your nose.
You're unusually happy today. There's a rosy glow about the cheeks.
Yes, sir. The mortician did a fine job. You look just like you did in life.
I happen to have a letter from the mayor, and he is congratulating me on 25 years in the civil service and is personally honoring me with a banquet, along with 286 others.
Wow, sir, the mayor. You know, when you meet the mayor, you should ask him what it is that you do for a living exactly.
Norm, I'm in such a good mood, I'm going to give a very favorable year-end report to your probation officer.
Oh, sir, thank you. I could kiss you, sir, except I think it might unleash something inside you, so I won't.
No.
So, Norm, a good report from Denby. That'll help you get an early release from your probation.
Yeah, this is great news. Oh, my God. This is his 25th anniversary. You know what? I had a real mean, nasty prank I had planned for him, and it's going to pay off today.
What is it?
I can't remember. That's the problem. I can't remember. I have some evil paperwork I can check here. See? Let me see. Valentine's Day, that's when I'm going to put the cow's heart in his desk. And,
you better remember what it is.
Yeah, I know. But I don't know how I will. Let me think now. Hey, you know what? Taylor was still working here when I had this plan. It was like a year ago. I'll phone her, and maybe she'll know. I got her message machine. Hi, Taylor, it's Norm. Give me a call. Oh, geez, I think I hit the wrong number. I'm re-recording her voice message. Hi, this is Taylor. I'm not home right now.
No, don't say you're not home. She'll get robbed.
I am home.
Yeah, but don't make it sound like she's all alone, all by herself.
Oh, I'm not alone. I'm home, but I'm not alone. But I'm Taylor. So, anyways, I'm here, and I'm with my boyfriend, a karate instructor, and me and him and the pet tiger will
wrap
be...
Wrap it up.
Taylor at the beat.
That you're not as smart as you thought you were in the first place. Too bad that you had to get caught. That's not like you to lose face. So sad that you're not as smart as you thought you were in the first place.
Too bad.
Too bad.
Too bad.
Too bad.
Too bad.
Too bad.
You know, I really think we should talk about yesterday when we held hands.
Keep your voice down. If this gets back to Norm, it's gonna be really awkward.
We're both nervous.
It's just I'm a worrier.
I'm a worrier too.
I mean, what if we tell Norm and then we go out and there's no chemistry? Then he'll be upset for nothing.
You're right. So you know what we should do? We should just go on a date. Find out if there's sparks. And if there are sparks, we'll tell Norm.
Okay, but what if one of us has sparks and the other one doesn't? Tell you what. Okay. After the date, we'll each write down on a piece of paper whether or not we had sparks. Then we'll exchange papers, and if they're both not sparks, we'll never speak of it again.
That's great. That's excellent.
Thanks.
Hey, Mr. Denby. I just got my AA welcome chip.
Don't get too attached to it.
Mr. Denby, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. You remember that banquet I told you about? Well, it turns out my nemesis, Bob Lane, is going to be there, and he's going to be bringing my ex-wife.
But how could a pathetic, lifeless man like you have a nemesis?
I don't know, but I do. Bob Lane, for 15 years, Bob Lane made my life at Water and Power miserable. Now he's going to ruin my banquet. He's bringing my ex-wife.
Well, that won't be so bad. Just don't pay any attention to them.
They're going to be the center of attention. Bob Lane is a great dancer. I'm just going to be forced to sit there and watch while he twirls around that two-bit whore.
No, you won't have to just sit there and watch. You look like you could cut a rug.
Oh, no, I can't.
Oh, come on.
I can't. Look at this. Look.
It's not good.
It's not. I'm not going to go to the banquet. I'm not going to go. You know, I've been planning my outfit for like 24 years.
It must be spectacular.
It is.
Well, it is. I'm a pretty decent dancer, so maybe I could show you a few things and get you through the banquet.
Really?
Yeah,
you
come over by my apartment tonight, and we'll start on some steps, okay?
Oh, listen, Lori, I think I have to tell you, though, in the 70s, I learned the hustle, and disco died. I don't think that was a coincidence.
Hey, Danny, I got some bad news, man. Shelly's seeing some guy, and I think it's serious.
How'd you hear about that?
Well, I befriended her hairdresser. Yeah, I've been getting information out of him all week.
Did you really do that?
Yeah. Problem is, he thinks we're dating. So, if I'm gonna pump him for any more information, then, you know, I'm gonna have to pump him for some.
You know, Norm, I mean, the hairdresser could be wrong.
Nah, I got a feeling about this. There's a guy. Yeah, when I find out who that guy is, Danny, I'm not gonna let him know that I know right away. I'm just gonna slowly drive him crazy.
Stop it! That's what I'll say. I'll say, stop it.
Wait a minute, it's you, isn't it? That's what I'll say to him. Wait a minute, it's you, isn't it?
Okay, Mr. Denby, you'll show him. Now, I figure we'll start out with a couple of basic steps. Do a combination with two twirls, and then you lift your partner up over your head.
You don't understand. I can't dance at all.
Oh.
When I was in high school, and I'd go to a dance, I'd have to get down on the floor and pretend I was tying my shoe for like 3 hours.
Mr. Denby, I know you think you can't do it, but you can, I promise you. Okay, now this is your dance space. This is my dance space. Now, lock your frame, no spaghetti arms. Focus right here. Ready, begin. One and two. Okay, that was my call.
I saw you walking down the street. I said, that's the kind of girl I'd like to meet. She's so pretty, Lord, she's fine. I'm gonna make a man of mine. Hey, hey, baby, I wanna know if you'll be my.
Hey, listen, Shelly, I realize I've been doing a lot of big, crazy things to try to get you to go out with me, and I realize what I should be doing is something small and classy.
Norm, stop.
No, hear me out. This is very romantic. Okay, now, the evening begins when you are picked up by a big yellow limousine with a meter. And then I take you to the most expensive restaurant in all of New York, where even before the waiter has a chance to bring the check, we dash off to catch the second act of the hottest show on Broadway. Now, how does that sound to you?
Listen very closely. I will never, ever, ever date you.
What? Really?
I don't know why this surprises you, Norm. I've been telling you this for months.
No. You've always said you'd never, ever date me. This is the first time you've ever said you'd never, ever, ever date me. I don't know why you're playing games with me like this.
I'm sorry, Norm.
That's all right. I guess if that's the way you feel, you know, that's the way you feel.
I didn't know what to say to him.
I'll go talk to him. Oh, God, Norm, I'm really, really sorry. You're gonna be all right?
Well, it kind of hurts, but I guess maybe it's for the best. I don't know.
You really feel that way?
Yeah, I do. Maybe it's time I should just accept this.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I'm starting to feel better about it already. You know, the Shelley Kilmartin chapter of my life is over. It's time to move on to chapter 8.
Well, that's really healthy, Norm.
Yeah, this is gonna be good, you know, because now with Shelley out of my brain, you know, I'll have a lot more space up there so I can, you know, whatever it is you do with your brain.
So you're really over her?
Yeah.
Well, that's great, because there's something I've been dying to tell you.
Okay, easy does it there, fella. I still like the ladies, you know.
No, Norm, it's just that the other guy that Shelley's interested in is me, and I was afraid you'd be upset.
Nah, I'm not upset, Danny. Listen, man, that's the way life goes, and good luck to both of you.
Oh, that's great, because I'm really happy, and Shelley is just terrific.
Of course she's terrific, you know. I mean, I especially think she's terrific because I'm still in love with her, you dirty bastard!
I'm so proud of you, sir. You did the lift!
Lori, I can't tell you how grateful I am for everything you've done for me. I feel like I should do a little something in return.
Oh, that's very sweet of you.
I'm gonna let you be my date for the civil service ball.
Holy... God.
No, Laurie, I want to do it. It's the least I can do.
That is way too generous, sir.
No, Laurie, Laurie, I want to do it for you.
I don't want to go.
Laurie, you don't want to go? All right, I'll find somebody else. Laurie, please, please, I can't get a woman.
Oh, God, all right. I'll do it. I'm going to smell like vodka.
Oh, hey, Norm. Hope you're still not mad at me.
Look, let me tell you something. I know why you did this. You're just trying to get back at me because Taylor liked me. But the difference was I didn't do anything because you were my best friend.
You said yourself that it was over between you and Shelley.
Yeah, well, if I said that I'd jump off the Brooklyn Bridge, would you do the same thing?
What does that have to do with anything?
Just answer the question.
Hey.
Oh, well, if it isn't Miss Baffling Choice in Sexual Partners.
I take it he's still mad at us.
No, I'm not mad. I wish you both good luck. But let me tell you something. I know both of you, and I know that neither one of you are very good in bed.
Norm.
Look, I don't even know why I'm talking to you, you know? Because you're not my friends anymore, you know? You are out of the gang.
What are you talking about?
The gang. You know the gang, when me and you and Artie and Lori, we all get together at my place and we do something fun, or maybe something that Lori wants to do, you know? Well, you're out of it now.
You're being silly, Norm.
No. I'm gonna replace you with better people. That's right. Smarter, funnier people. And we're gonna do all kinds of fun stuff. We'll go on road trips and we'll give out scholarships. You watch. All right, I think this whole gang thing's working out great, isn't it? How about some Chinese food there, everybody?
I hope there's no peanuts in the Chinese food. If I eat a peanut, my throat swells right up and I die.
Yeah. Well, hey, you know what we used to do when Danny and Shelley were part of the gang? Is we'd tell funny stories. Anybody got a funny story?
Once, I let a bunch of high school boys fill me up for a sip of their beer.
Yeah, that's a funny story. All right. Hey, Mike, what do you got there? You got anything?
Well, this isn't a story, but knock, knock.
Yeah. Don't tell me the rest. I got to get some soy sauce.
Norm, this new gang sucks.
Yeah, it's creepy. They just sit there and stare at us.
Come on, guys, give them a chance, would you? Come on. Hey, guys, hey, how about we play a game, huh? Charades, always fun. I got a bowl here with some clues already written in it. Mike, why don't you start, huh? Come on there.
Okay. I'm ready. Scarlet, your dress is made of curtains.
Hey, he can't talk.
Mike, I should have been more clear. We're gonna play the non-talking charades. Okay, let's go.
Oh, look, I'm dancing with wolves.
Tower Inferno! No, do you listen? Do you hear? He said it. He said he's dancing with the damn wolves.
Hey, good job, buddy. Now find out what she's allergic to.
Look at them, him and my ex-wife. They dance like a dream, like Fred Astaire and Ginger Bucket of Crap.
Yeah, but I bet they can't do the lift.
Yeah.
Come on, let's take the floor. Nobody puts Denby in a corner.
Watch this. I can't do it. I can't do the lift. Not only just watch it.
The lift is the whole thing, sir. You
can't. I can't.
Sir, I'm not gonna let you look foolish. Well, I had fun.
Yeah, me too.
So, do you think we crossed the line between friendship and dating-ship?
Actually, this isn't going to be a real date until we kiss.
You're completely right. We should kiss.
Okay. That was nice.
I thought so, too. But, you know, I do kiss friends sometimes, so maybe we should kiss longer.
Ooh, hey, you know what friends never do?
Yeah. But I think we should take it slowly.
Yeah, I know. I got carried away. It's just that I haven't had this much fun since,
Since what?
Nothing.
You were going to say since you went out with Taylor, weren't you?
I know I'm getting over her.
But you're not completely over her yet.
It's a slow process.
Yeah. I know it is. And I understand.
You know, I won't really know if I've gotten over her until I've been with another woman.
Excellent try, Danny. Good night.
Okay.
We don't need a gang, Wiener Dog. Me and you will be our own gang, huh, buddy?
I'll get it.
Doug, I don't want to go. You're just being polite. You go ahead.
Hey.
Taylor?
Hey. I just saw 6 dogs get out of a cab.
Yeah. Well, apparently wiener dogs are having some kind of a party or something.
So, Norm, I got your message.
Oh, yeah, the message. Oh, yeah, that was nothing. Yeah, I just couldn't remember a gag I was going to pull on Denby.
Oh. I was kind of hoping you called because you wanted to see me.
Oh, well, look, Taylor, you know that I'd really like to be with you and everything, but that'd cause a lot of trouble down at the office.
And Danny's still hung up on me?
Yeah. Well, actually, he's not. He's going out with another girl now.
Really? Well, that's great.
Why is that great? Oh. Over the last 4 weeks, we've been telling you about the Write Norm's Punchline contest, and since then, thousands of you have sent in your jokes. Tune in next week and see if you're one of 4 lucky winners whose joke was picked to be used on our show. Now, here comes Wiener Dog with another one of his entries. All right. Oh, good Lord, Wiener Dog. I can't say this is filthy. I couldn't even say this on cable.